A stomach-turning story out of Enid. A mother and grandmother charged for chaining a teenager with special needs to a couch.
We do want to warn viewers, the information and the images contained in this report are disturbing. News 4's Natalie Clydesdale is in Enid with details.
Well, court records show the mother and grandmother initially told police the scabs surrounding the teen's ankle were from a dog bite. But eventually, they confessed they had trouble controlling the 17-year-old, and that's why they say they chained her up. Again, we want to warn you, the details in this story are graphic.
Sorry, how can I help you?
We didn't need a welfare check done on the testimony following.
Concern filled two Dobson Fiber employees as they caught a glimpse of a troubling sight while installing a woman's home internet service.
She has her daughter chained to a couch and the daughter's special needs.
Officers went out to the home.
Inside, police saw the 17-year-old stuck on a recliner couch with a chain around her left ankle and locked with a padlock. The chain ran to the frame of the recliner.
Terrible. I can't believe that anybody would do that.
This picture shows the scabs and cuts surrounding the teen's ankle and foot. Court records say the injuries are consistent with a chain being wrapped around her ankle and pulled, quote, very tight.
Judging from the scabbing of the wounds and the scarring, that it had been some significant amount of time.
Court records show the teen's grandmother, Mildred Perez, told police the teen, quote, always runs away and was stronger than them, and she is dangerous to herself and others. Meanwhile, the documents revealed Jennifer Perez, the teen's mother, said, quote, the police and DHS don't help them, and that is why they chained her to the couch.
You just have to contact local authorities, GHS, that sort of a thing to get the help you need.
It's not clear who is caring for the teen now, but both Mildred and Jennifer Perez are charged with abuse by caretaker and conspiracy to commit child abuse. In Enid, Natalie Clydesdale, Oklahoma's News 4.